everybody. It is 10:45. Yeah, I kind of got a late start on vlogging. Happy Vlogmas Day 12. The boys are actually sleeping now. Jaden got up early at like 6 something, I think, and he quietly came in here to the dining room and was like coloring or something. Or he was looking at a magazine or it was laying in here or something. He was quiet for once. And then Levi woke up about 7:30, and by that time I had already decided, well, I guess it's time to get up. And I come in here, and I went to the kitchen and made them both pancakes. I had some pancakes too, ain't gonna lie. But anyway, I've pretty much just been, I did get the vacuum out and vacuum all around the floors, because last night, you know, we had Subway, and there were some crumbs and just stuff you don't really notice at night, or you're too tired to worry about noticing at night. And so I just took care of it this morning. And my husband, on Saturdays, he usually has to get up at like 4:40, and he's out the door by 4:45. And so I got up and made him some coffee real quick, and he already had an extra Subway little half sandwich to take with him, because he told me last night to give him an extra one just for today. So he's going to have a short day, because he's got to be out of there by 3 o'clock because of the party tonight that starts at 6. And so I got all the dishes done up. There's just a few to put away, and I got some clothes washing and some drying. Figure, well, you know, why not? And so I went ahead and fed the boys their leftovers from last night, and Levi got finished first, and he went to sleep. And then when Jaden got done, I told him it would be a good idea for him to take a nap too, whether he does or not. If he lays quietly in there, that's fine, as long as he don't wake his little brother up. So, I actually did not get no coffee until, I sound like old Hick, don't I? Get no coffee? My husband would be proud if he heard me talking. anyway, I didn't get coffee until about 10:15. It's on my bed. Is that late? It is for me, because I don't have it, you know, right away. I'm not one of these people that, oh, I gotta have my coffee, or I'm crazy, and all this. You know, I just drink coffee because, I don't know, the idea of it maybe, or the taste of it sometimes. And so I haven't had a shower yet or nothing. I'm still wearing, you know, what I slept in, and this is my hairdo. Got it in a ponytail. In a little while I'll probably go get a shower. I don't know when that's going to happen. My husband told me last night, get all dolled up for me. He's so funny. He was basically also saying, just basically go ahead and get ready before I get home. That way all we got to do is him come in, get in the shower and everything, and we load the boys up and got to carry them to my in-laws. I thought Jaden was coming down the hallway. To my in-laws' house where we were the other day, because they're about 15-minute drive from here, I guess. And so, I wished that she would just come over here, but one of my husband's, I say my husband's niece, because it's his side of the family more than it is mine. One of the nieces will be over there, and she's crazy about Levi, but I'm not crazy about the fact that she's crazy about Levi, because the other day she was letting him put AA batteries in his mouth, and he could have choked on them. And so, just that kind of stuff bothers me. But my husband talked to my mother-in-law about it, and she's gonna have everything picked up supposedly. And I'm still not okay with all that. I'm just, because my baby doesn't like to even go be around my mother-in-law. He likes everybody else, but he doesn't like her. Ever since she watched him one time when I had to have an emergency appendicitis situation go on, she had to come over and watch him for us, because it was like, I was like kept overnight or whatever, and he ever since then would not have nothing to do with her. And this was back July the 3rd, I think, when that happened. I did a video on it. If you can look for it, I was talking about the situation. But look, I got a Texas cup. Yes, I have been to Texas. I had this a long time ago. Anyway, excuse me for doing that. So there's a little chit chat here going on. So I have been sitting here, let me just show you, going over the Boxcar Grill's menu, trying to figure out what I want and what looks good and that kind of thing. So, yeah. It's hard to think about what you want to eat when it's 10 something in the morning, what you want for dinner. I mean, sometimes. Well, it'll come to me, I'm sure, the closer it gets. I'll have a couple of things narrowed down, and then I'll decide then, because Jerry said that he was told that we can order anything we want off the menu. No one can get alcohol, which is fine, because we don't drink anyway. So we can pretty much get whatever we want. I said, oh, good, I'll get one of everything. That wasn't funny. There's something else I was going to mention to y'all. I think it's been raining outside because, see, the roads are a little bit wet out there. Here, I'll show y'all. Let me see if y'all can see what I'm talking about. So, you see where it's kind of like there's like dark and light out there? And it's like real foggy. You can't even see the mountains or nothing. It's so foggy. But, my neighbor's out there doing something. He's spying on him. He's kind of a creeper. He's out there filling holes or something. Yeah, the other day, well, I say the other day, back in October when we moved in here, I was outside doing something, and I heard someone go, hello. And I was looking, and I didn't see nobody. And it was because he was so skinny that he was, like, basically it just happened to be that he was lined up with the pole that holds up our carport. And so I'm like, couldn't see him. And I'm like, hi, after I figured, you know. But, yeah. So, I guess it's probably really noisy because my washing machine is filling up with water. So, on that note, we'll take a break for a little bit. So, I got a shower. It's exactly 1 o'clock now. And I was going to give Levi actually just got from a nap. I told Jaden that they were going to need to get their baths before they go to Nana's, right? So, Jaden wanted to play in the tub, and I was like, okay, we got enough time for that, but let me give Levi his bath first. Well, I went in there to run the water, and the water's coming out brown. And just to show you, well, maybe it's clearing up.
Okay.
See?
Hey, it's not.
And it was darker than that a little while ago. And I kind of tried to search it out. And I read something about the fire stations flushing fire hydrants or something. I don't know what that's all about. And it's Saturday, and I can't get a hold of no one at, like, the public works or whatever. And I had some clothes that... Get out of there, Levi. That needed to be rinsed out because... let me just show you. Hang on. In one of my pajama pants, this little guy here got wrapped up in it, so there was still some in there. So, I was like, let me rinse. See, you can see it's kind of... Let's see, get down there. Brown down in there with the water sitting there. So, I hurried up and, like, drained it. And just, I'm glad I didn't have my white clothes in there yet or something. I don't know if this is going to stain. I'm just, you know, my husband's going to be getting home soon. Thank you for throwing it on the floor where it'll be all sticky. Throwing his little water cup. He's trying to get into something, so. Levi Davis, get out of there. Now, that's glass that'll fall and break. We had a chair there, and I was, you know, thinking, oh, I'll be smart and move it. Not smart, so I need to drag it back over here. Sorry if you're looking at the ceiling. Right then. Try to angle this chair right next to it, like so. So that he will try to stay out of it. Here, you want to go down the hallway? Go to Bubba's room. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Get you. He usually runs real fast and does like a bring them into the wall. So anyway, just a check-in. I was trying to get them ready because my husband would be getting off work at 3, a couple hours. Oh, look, that's Mama's phone. Thank you kindly. Oh, no, it's going to be one of them days. So, I gotta do something with this hair. I just put on basically just some bum-around clothes until it's time to get ready. Him not happy. Gotta take a break. Gotta go be mama for a minute. Okay, so I'm back and I've got a little update. It's now 1:30. I was able to kind of Google some people to talk to and about this water situation, and they were saying to call the police department. You know, so I called them and I said, "Have y'all been getting any calls about people with brown water?" And she said, "Yes, ma'am." So she said there was a line break and they've got to wait for the pressure to build back up before they can flush it. So I called my husband because he's in a different county where he works. And, I mean, it's like you're in our county and then you make a curve and you're in another county and then you're back in another curve and you're back in our county. It's kind of weird. And I called him and got a hold of him. And I said, before you come home, you might want to clean up the best you can there, because he looks like black when he's done work. Because he's a diesel mechanic, so he loves to get dirty and he makes a mess of it. But when he comes home, he's able to get cleaned up. But I said, you might want to go ahead and clean up while you're there, because he keeps extra clothes there, and I think they have a shower and all that. But he kind of laughed, like, when I said, you might want to clean up. He said he actually wasn't that bad today, and they were kind of getting finished up. So I don't know if he's going to be there exactly till 3, or if he's going to get to leave before 3. But I'm glad at least I got my shower out of the way. Yeah, that way, I mean, if I need to, I can just take some clothes, and they can have baths at Nana's house if they need to. Or I can do it tonight. Because we're only going to stay out a couple hours. We're not going to stay out as late as everybody else. And we just want to get back home and do our own thing. Yeah. Because my husband's off tomorrow. He's off on Sundays. And as long as he ain't got a bunch of stuff to have to deal with. Because he was thinking if they have to stop working immediately at 3, then whatever's left, he's going to have to come in and finish it tomorrow on his day off, which is more money, and he's fine with that. But I think they're actually going to get it all squared away today. So he'll have his time off. So, yeah. I seen a grizzly movie we wanted to watch. I seen it on Redbox. It's called, it's not that one with Billy Bob Thornton in it. It's not The Grizzly Maze or whatever. It's another one. It shows a girl named Jennifer on the front cover. That's her name, her character name, or who she is. And it's based off a true story. And that looked good. I was thinking about getting that. We might reserve that and then, pick it up on the way to or from the restaurant. Actually, we could get it right across the street from the restaurant because they have a Redbox right there, because there's, a Lowe's food store and a Dollar General store right there that have red boxes, because we used to live over that way. And we just never ate at that restaurant this whole time. I used to always want to go there, and we just didn't really at the time have the money to be doing it. And it was before I was pregnant, and then I got pregnant with Levi, and we were in the transition of moving, and it was just a big financial mess at the time. And we just tried to not eat out at all, and I wanted to eat there so bad. Now we're going there to eat for free. Isn't it funny how things work out? Please go put that in the garbage. Jaden's in his play clothes. Look how short those pants are. That's why they're play clothes. He's using his backhoe loader to throw his Go-Gurt wrapper away. And yeah, you dressed yourself. Yeah, you look like you're wearing karate pants, boy.
And he does a good job working.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He can work by himself.
Yeah.
Levi's eating bananas over there. And I'll help him if he needs help.
Yeah, good job.
I'm a good helper.
You want some of your cran apple juice, Papa? Say yes, ma'am. Y'all have some, Mom.
His little whining, what are you going to call it? Tangent? Tiff? Or whatever it is he was doing a while ago was mainly, I think, because he was really hungry. Because when he did eat lunch, they ate an early lunch at like 10. But really, Levi didn't eat much of his sandwich at all, now that I think about it. So I made him a peanut butter jelly sandwich, and then I gave him some bananas. You like that, don't you? He gobbled it right on up to that sandwich. That's one of his favorite things. He's like his daddy. He likes peanut butter. I don't care for peanut butter unless it's got chocolate involved, like a Reese's cup or something like that. But my husband, good Lord, that man could eat peanut butter just every day, all day. I mean, he loves himself some peanut butter. Yeah. And he'll take and, like, put just straight up peanut butter on bread and, like, dip it in milk. Ugh. And then he, what else does he do? He likes to put it on his waffles with syrup, and I cannot stand the smell of maple syrup. It's like, I mean, I like to eat it on pancakes, but that's it. That's where it ends right there. I don't want to smell it on my fingers or my kids' fingers, or I have to clean it, and like the hot water makes you smell whatever you're cleaning, and it's all around not good for me. And like when I make my son just recently, my older one, just recently started liking peanut butter sandwiches for school. And so then when I wash the butter knife off, I'm like, I hate the texture of it. I don't like touching it. But I mean, obviously I have to touch it, clean it, but it's just not good for me. What kind of content, while we're having this little chit-chat, what kind of content do y'all want to see from me? Like what I'm doing now, the little day in the life kind of things, do you want it? I mean, I know they've been a little rather long, like in the 20-minute mark-ish, give or take a penny kind of thing. And do you want me to make them shorter, like say 10 minutes, keep them about where they're at? I mean, what do y'all want to see? I mean, I want y'all to see what y'all want to see. So give me some ideas what you might want to talk about, or if you have any questions, if you want me to do like an answer question kind of thing, or anything like that, I'd be glad to try to work that in there for you. So y'all be thinking about that, and shoot me some messages on that. Jaden's playing at the table. Levi's doing what Levi does best, making baby noises. This, you know, the life of mom, huh? So, it's a rather nice day. It's probably about 70 degrees outside, maybe 68, 69. I don't want to push it and say 70 because Jaden went out a while ago and it was like a little bit chilly, I thought, but he didn't want a coat on or a jacket or nothing like that. So I'm thinking it's at least 68, 69-ish. It could have been it might have been 65. I don't really know. But, anyway, my husband will be driving us this evening. it's a little bit like we're on a date. But we always go in my vehicle because we haven't yet purchased an extra car seat for his vehicle. We have two booster seats for Jaden, and we always have because I used to have a different vehicle way back when we met. I had a Ford Explorer, and so we had gotten an extra booster seat for Jaden for his truck. And so anyway, when Levi came along, we just had narrowed it down. I sold my vehicle right before I had him, and we used that money to go toward anything baby related that we needed. And I mean, because when we originally moved over here from Florida up here to North Carolina, I mean, I was working and planning on going back to work, and then I got pregnant and everything, and then Jaden was fixing to start kindergarten, and I kind of wanted to spend the last little year before he did all that, you know, because he's growing so fast. And I've been a stay-at-home mom basically since we've moved up here for going on 3 years now. And I mean, I was planning on getting some kind of doing something. going back into my line of work, but which is like the security law enforcement field. And years ago I did retail and stuff. But I mean, I've always wanted Jaden. Is that you or him?
That me.
Yeah.
That's Levi.
You gonna blame it on Levi?
Huh?
Really? But anyway, I was doing retail and stuff, but I always wanted to do cake decorating. I think I would just be so good at that. That would be like a passion to just, and I'm not talking about decorating kids' cakes. I'm talking about like doing them ones you see on Food Network where they're like doing the basket weave and making cakes match dresses and stuff. Huh?
Can I put the phone on charge?
Yeah, I think it's already on charge, ain't it?
I'm talking about
the white one?
That one.
Yeah, you can go put it on charge.
Okay.
We have an old iPhone that I downloaded a bunch of free games on from Apps Gone Free. Mm-hmm. And that's basically his phone to do stuff on when he's allowed to do it. Learning games. Oh, that phone. That's the regular house phone you're putting on charge. Yeah, you can do that. Anyway, so, but I think that it would be so cool to do cake decorating. I mean, I was like going to try to get on with like a local grocery store that just did stuff. I would have done it for free. I mean, I think there's nothing better than loving what you do and getting paid for it. Like my husband, he loves what he does and loves going to work, and then he gets paid for it too. I mean, that's the kind of job people need. You don't want to, I mean, if you're the kind of person that don't want to be around people, well, here's a career for you. Go be a dog washer. Because, hey, you got to be around nobody but dogs. But, and there's some people that I've wondered how they even manage to be in, like, customer service, like retail and stuff, and taking your order. And then some of these restaurants, these chicks will come up, and these guys or girls, whatever you want to call it, you tell them what you want, and they don't write it down no more. They just, like, memorize it. I'm like, you're going to remember all that? And they're like, yeah. I'm like, you're in the wrong line of work. You need to be, like, in acting or something, you know, or magician or something. I mean, if you can memorize all that. I can't. I'm lucky if I can remember to bounce a checkbook. So, sorry for the little long chit-chat just now. Probably the next time you see me, I will have gotten dressed up or gussied up, as my husband likes to call it, and he and I will be on the next video. Yes.
Turn it off.
We're going to the party.
Mm-hmm.
We just dropped the kids off. We gave them McDonald's and dropped them off. Say something intelligent. Get your spit bottle. That's not intelligent.
Yeah, it is. You want me to stay sane, don't you?
Y'all doing okay?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Good. Can I go ahead and start y'all off with something to drink?
Sweet tea.
Okay.
Sweet tea.
Cut up for you too. What? I get for you to drink.
We are here.
Yes.
Hey. They got a little train up there.
Now you're just confused. What do you want?
I got sirloin
tips.
What you got?
Sure.
That rib eye thing.
Out of bounds steak. Knock the horns off.
Knock the horns off.
Okay.
Yep.
Interesting. Do y'all need anything else over here?
I did have a job.
Maybe we had to work. Okay.
I do need the salt and pepper.
Okay.
$50. There you go, honey.
You.
But this is my pocket.
It's fun, huh?
You're so cute. Hey everybody, we're back home now. We just got back from my in-laws and picking the boys up, and now they're getting ready for bed, and my husband's already changed and getting Levi ready for bed, and so I'm fixing to change out of this and get ready to probably watch a movie. I still can't remember the two movies we got. That one movie with the bear was Backcountry or Back something. And then the other movie I picked, I can't remember the name of it. I picked it for my husband to watch. We had a nice time. My husband won a $50, we thought it was a $50 check, but it ended up being $50 in cash in the envelope. And so you saw him get that. So I'm sorry I only got a little bit of footage of the food and what was going on. I just didn't really, you know, there's people there I didn't know and stuff. So I just kind of felt weird about whipping my camera out for them to see. But anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow. I've got to do some shopping tomorrow, like pick up some gift cards or something for some of my brothers and sister-in-laws and stuff like that. And so, yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.